at Marvel, we used to work in what's called Marvel style, which is the writer writes a very detailed plot. So maybe for a 23-page story, there'll be a 6, 7, 8-page plot. Single space, broken down page by page. Sometimes I don't ever do it panel by panel, with explaining what's going on, suggested dialogue, what the emotions are. And then that goes to the artist draws that. I get those pages back. And then, in looking at the artwork, I put in the captions, I put in the dialogue. And so that way of working is so important for the writer and artist to be in sync. Because what can happen is, I may visualize it a certain way, I get those pages back, and I look at the page and I see that what I saw in my head wasn't there. And sometimes what happens is, you have to explain what's in the pictures. If you think it's going to be clear, and suddenly you have your character saying things like, I'm jumping off the roof now because it's not clear inside the picture, you know? When you work with an artist like Zach, the storytelling is perfectly clear. You see the emotions on the characters' faces. So those what I call the first couple of levels are all very clear. I don't have to explain what's happening in the panel. No one has to say I'm jumping off the roof or I'm punching you in the nose because it's not clear in the pictures. That allows me as the writer to go do what we were talking about before, to go deeper. The pictures are telling one story, and then in the script, I'm telling a psychological story, and a story of the deeper emotions, and you dig deeper and deeper and deeper. And then another example that I always go to is when I was working with Sal Buscema on this diagram. You did The Death of Harry Osborn, The Green Goblin. So at the end of that story, there's 3 or 4 pages, Harry dies, and he dies in Peter's arms, and they go off together in the ambulance. In my head, when I wrote the plot and explained everything to Sal, I thought I was going to write a lot. I thought I was going to really boost the emotions, and there would be dialogue, and there would be melodramatic captions, and all this going on. I got the artwork out from Sal, and if you look at that book, everything I asked for in my plot was already there. So those last, I think, 3 pages of the story, there's not a word on the page, because I didn't have to do it. That's the advantage of working that way when it works with the right artist.